Hello, everybody. Welcome back to James's Classic Movies. I apologize for the delay. This is Monday, and I should have had a video out Saturday. I was a little under the weather. You get the picture. You've been there yourselves. I'm sure you have. But anyway, we're going to talk today about the Wild Wild West. A Western sci-fi classic Western show. That aired in 1965 and lasted to 1969. Of course, you can see reruns on it on the Western Channel. Again, it lasted 4 seasons, 104 episodes. It was a very, very good show, and I'm sure you've seen the Will Smith version of it. But it would lead you to believe in things that we believe weren't possible. It was also complimentary to shows like Star Trek, Batman, and Lost in Space, and other Western TV shows such as The High Chaparral, Cheyenne, Big Valley, Bonanza, starring Robert Conrad as Captain Jim West, Ross Martin as Artemis Gordon, along with Dick Kangaree. And of course, a special appearance by James Gregory as President Grant. Take a look at this, and this is going to be filmed in black and shown to you in black and white, although it was the whole series was shot in color. And well, take a look at this. Let me stop running along here.
New this fall on your favorite channel. Western adventure with the excitement of espionage. The Wild Wild West, starring Robert Conrad as undercover man James West. His assignments, top secret, dangerous.
Don't bother, Mr. West.
I sure hope you enjoyed that and consider picking up a copy of that. It's well worth investment. And if you're into Westerns and testing the classic Westerns, you'll definitely be into the Wild Wild West. We saw villains and people starting their careers in acting kick off on these shows. A lot of famous character actors back in the time. James Gregory, who appeared on many shows, F Troop, Hogan's Heroes, and the like, was there to play President Grant on the opening pilot, along with Michael Dunn. Michael Dunn played Dr. Loveless, was a character actor, and also a world-renowned concert violinist. So when you saw him pick up a violin on the show, you know he really knew how to play it. Also starring Richard Kiel, because every time you see Dr. Loveless, you see Richard Kiel. He played roles as Mr. Jaws. And then you had Victor Bruno, a well-known character actor. Ricardo Montalban, you remember him from Khan on Star Trek. And, of course, Fantasy Island. Kathy Brown. Marge Ducey, you remember her from as a character actor in big shows like Hawaii Five-O, Hogan's Heroes, Suzanne Pleshette, and Antoinette Bauer, also from Hogan's Heroes, and other big TV series back at the time. A lot of actors back in the 60s, as we know today, got their starts there as character actors. Just not all actors got a big break and thrown into a huge movie as a star. Back in, you had to earn it. Okay, now let's talk about another movie here. This movie is the spinoff of The Wild Wild West. In 1999, Will Smith and Kevin Kline, remember him from Silverado, stepped in to the limelight to bring back to the screen The Adventures of James West and Artemis Gordon. A well-shot movie. To me, it's a little over the top, but that's me. And more comedy than anything. Take a look at this and you judge for yourself.
Not getting enough lift. We need more speed. Gordy, that's a cliff.
Yes, I know.
That means the ground is going to end.
Yes, I know.
Gordon.
Before there was a Secret Service, there was
West. Jim West.
West, Jim West, Desperado, Rough Rider. No, you don't want nada. None of this. It's gunning this, brother running. James West, Tame of the West. So remember the name. Now who you gonna call?
Not the GB.
Now who you gonna call? Test your chest, Loveless. Can't stand the heat to get out the wild.
Or just a handsome cowboy who likes to poke around.
I believe I'm that second one.
Gotta stick to what we each do best.
From the director of Men in Black.
Now what?
Let the party begin!
Will Smith. Kevin Kline.
Bon voyage.
I love this train.
Kenneth Branagh. And Selma Hayek. And it's a whole new West.
Well, we hope you enjoyed that and consider adding that one as well to your Wild Wild West collection in your library. For the note, a footnote for you to consider or entertain, it cost $170 million to produce the Will Smith version of the Wild Wild West. bringing in at the box $222 million. Most people will consider that a poor showing, considering what it cost to make it, bringing in roughly $45 million. So, although it was, you know, to me it was it's a pretty good movie. Of course, I liked the TV series better. Again, we hope that you will pick up The Wild Wild West and add it to your collection. It's well worth the money and lots of hours of entertainment. Until next time, I'm James with James's Classic Movies. We'll see you next week.